Afternoon, depending on where you are, depending on where you're watching me from. It is just unbelievable what I've seen. What I've seen this afternoon in the news. So this is gonna be one of the things that I'm going to discuss. I'm going to discuss this evening in my broadcast. Because when we are talking about the fact that different groups should come together to disintegrate Nigeria, you see, disintegrating Nigeria is just as easy as anything. Disintegrating Nigeria is very, very easy. So you are watching me directly and live now on YouTube and in Facebook at the same time. This broadcast is simultaneously being aired in YouTube and in Facebook. This is not my normal broadcast, of course. I'm going to give you a background of what we are going to discuss this evening. And the point here is that when I come across this breaking news, that a group of our sociocultural group, different sociocultural organization has taken the presidency of Nigeria. Of course, here the respondent is Buhari, but I'm not going to address as it is. So I will say they have taken the presidency to court on lopsided appointment. You see, I really don't understand. Of course, I wouldn't say I really don't understand, because I do understand. I do understand why our people will choose to do the wrong thing at the right time. You see, this evening I am going to call on the Ohaneze Ndi Igbo, the Fenifere, the Niger Delta, Pandef, what they call the Middle Belt, as well. I'm going to make something very clear to them. You see, no right thing to do, you choose to do the wrong thing. You see, how can you know what to do and then you are using the right thing to do the wrong thing? You see, you are taking the presidency to court. You are taking Buhari or whoever that is in Aso Rock to court for lopsided appointment. And what really caught my attention here is that for these three major sociocultural organization, or even four major sociocultural organization, to have come together to file a suit against the presidency means that we are not far from disintegration. We are not far from dividing Nigeria. And it is very, very simple. We also know that a lot of, when it comes to Biafra, especially the Igbo-speaking part of Biafra, a lot of people don't trust Ohaneze Ndi Igbo. In fact, the majority of Igbos don't trust them. So they may not have the mandate. They may not have the mandate of the majority of the Igbo-speaking part of Biafra. That is one. Two is that unlike Oduduwa Republic, unlike Yoruba people hold Afenifere in very high esteem. So they enjoy some level of trust within Yoruba nation. They enjoy trust, this Afenifere. Now this Pandef, knowing how our brothers and sisters, the people of the riverine area of Biafra, how they behave, we would also say that they hold this Pandef in a very high esteem, even though they are not to be trusted. Now, in the Middle Belt, of Nigeria, we do not know much about the kind of respect, dignity, and integrity the organization here enjoys in that Middle Belt of Nigeria. So, but let me quickly read what this report says. And I am going to tell you with this what I just see today, dividing and disintegrating Nigeria is just in our finger. And this is exactly what we have been looking for. So whatever that is needed to be done should be channeled at disintegrating Nigeria. Nigeria is not working again, and they can never work again. Nigeria will never, ever, ever work. It has become an irredeemable country and can never work. So anything any group want to do must be channeled at disintegrating Nigeria, not to addressing or redress the so-called marginalization or injustice being meted at a particular group also. So for example, for the fact that these three or four region has come together to file a lawsuit demanding one thing, and which means both all the regions involved in this lawsuit has been systematically sidelined and has been affected by the terrorist control government of Nigeria. Now, you don't need to go and start doing argument or debating with anybody whether or not the region I am going to mention here has actually been affected by this terrorist-controlled Nigeria government or not. The answer is as clear as anything. The answer, when you go out of your house, wherever you are, if you are in Yoruba land, go out of your house, you are going to see the answer. If you are in Biafra land, go out of your house, you are going to see the answer. If you are in Middle Belt, go out of your house, you are going to see the answer right there waiting for you. Now, this news read, breaking, Fasoranti Clark Nwodo, 13 orders, sue Buhari over lopsided appointment. What is it in appointment that you people are wasting time to sue Buhari over ordinary lopsided appointment, when in actual sense you should be agitating for disintegration of Nigeria, because the action of the government so far has constituted the act of dividing Nigeria. It shows that Nigeria is not one. It shows that Nigeria can never be one. It shows that the president from the top, from the day he assumed office, started the disintegration of Nigeria. And what this group should have done or could have done is to take the advantage of the fact that the government, the terrorist government itself, has divided Nigeria. So why are they going to court to seek a redress of appointment, of a lopsided appointment by the president? And at the same time, you see why people cannot trust these people? You see why the region cannot trust these people? At the same time, they are demanding 50 billion damages for lopsided appointment. Who needs 50 billion? What are you going to do with 50 billion? The money that have been pumped into the different region is more than 50 billion, and there is nothing to show for it for ages. So what are we going to do with 50 billion? Let's assume that the government pays you 50 billion. If the government pays 50 billion to you and you take the money, you see now that that is exactly why people are insulting you. You see the reason why people are insulting the elders. Elders in Ohanaeze Ndi Igbo. You see the reason why the Igbos are insulting you. You see the reason why people in IPOB are insulting you. Because they have continued to insult you believing that you continue to convince them, you have continued to convince them that anything you do is all about money. Life is not all about money. The life of an average Nigerian, the life of an average Biafran doesn't depend on money. Everything is not about money. It has come to the point that the right to live is the most important thing in life of Nigerians than money. The right to life, the right to live, the right of association, the right to live freely in your own indigenous land has become the biggest priority of anybody living in Biafra, living in southern Nigeria. Money is nothing to anybody now. First of all, you need to be alive for you to enjoy 50 billion. You need to be alive for you to use good road. You need to be alive for you to have infrastructure. You need to be alive to use hospital. You need to be alive to go to good school. You need to be alive to do anything you want to do in this life. You need to be alive to collect the 50 billion if government decide to compensate you with 50 billion naira. You need to be alive to collect that money. So if you file a lawsuit and the only thing you are interested in filing lawsuit against the government is to go and seek for 50 billion compensation, what if before the money will be released to you, you were killed or you get killed? What are you going to tell the people in the spirit? That you were going to collect money and they kill you? Are you going to be proud to stand in front of God in the judgment day that instead of doing the right thing by fighting for the rights to life of your people, you decided to fight for compensation, you decided to fight for 50 billion naira, and because of the 50 billion, the same government that will probably release the 50 billion to you will also arrange that assassin that will come to kill you. So you are going to tell God that I left the duty, I left the reason I was created to this life to go and fight for the life and the precious life of people to go and start chasing shadow. In chasing your shadow, you collect 50 billion. If you are not killed during the time you want to collect the money, you will be killed after you have collected the money. And at the end of the day, you will have your name dented. You will have your name, rubbished. You will never be trusted. Your lineage will never be trusted. What are you going to gain by filing a lawsuit against a government that is a terrorist government? You see, one thing I have to tell Ohanaeze Ndigbo and to every group, including Afenifere, is that for all of you to have come together to even have a single, purpose of going to court, to even come together to agree that you have to file a lawsuit, means that the Nigeria disintegration is not far. It is in you. It is in your hand. And you cannot continue to romance this thing because you can see that this thing is not working again. This thing can never work again. You people should stop beating around the bush and make decisions to save the life of your people. Fulani are here to kill, whether you believe it or not. They are here to kill you. They are here to kill your women, rape your women, rape your children, kill them and grab your land. As I'm talking to you today, in Imo State, in Biafra land, another head has been chopped off, another two was butchered, another three was butchered, and they will continue to butcher this every day, every blessed day, and nobody will ever be arrested. Remember, each one person that is killed by Fulani, it goes a very long way to put fear in thousands and thousands of people living in that community. So the idea of killing people and butchering them is to create fear. That is what terrorists use. They want to terrorize you, use fear to take whatever that did not belong to them, or put fear in you so that you will meet their demand. In this particular Fulani herdsmen, the idea, their demand is not made known, but we all know their demand. The demand is that whenever you see them in the bush, don't interfere. Whenever you see their houses in your forest, in your farmland, don't interfere. Whenever you see their cattle in your farmland, don't interfere. That is the message they want to send to you. And if you continue to interfere, they will continue to butcher people in your community. And until you people begin to be afraid of them, that anytime you see them in your farmland, you start running. That is exactly what they are looking for. So they want to create this fear. Now, instead of these people, instead of this group, to start fighting for disintegration of Nigeria, because Nigeria can never work again. Instead of them to fight for disintegration of Nigeria, they go to court to go and demand for compensation of 50 billion. How much is 50 billion naira? How much is 50 billion? How much is 50 billion that will be the price of lives of people in your region? This is honestly an insult to every region that is part of this lawsuit, to every region that this sociocultural organization represents. Let me make it clear. Few days ago, the government of Nigeria released about 13 billion naira to fight locust, to fight grasshopper, to fight all these ants in the northern Nigeria, in the 12 northern states. Now, minus 13 billion from 50 billion, how much is it? How much is it? Why would you stoop this low? Instead of you people to go and start fighting for freedom of your people, you go and start demanding for 50 billion. Let me read what I have just come across today, and it is a breaking news. But like I say, I am going to address this issue this evening. I am not here now to start telling you, you know, to tell you what they have done. I am just telling you I'm just here to tell you, to remind those people who have jointly done this, that they are not far from the process of disintegrating Nigeria. Do you know how disintegration of Nigeria is going to happen? There are many ways to disintegrate Nigeria. Forget all these people that say they are going to court to disintegrate Nigeria. It is not possible. Forget all those who say you have to tell your representative to go to National Assembly and pronounce them. It is not possible. Forget them. That will never, ever happen. The way to disintegrate Nigeria is by coming together, Yoruba, Igbo, Yoruba, Biafra, and the Middle Belt coming together, just like you have in this lawsuit. All this region must come together and invoke Section 14 of the 1999 Constitution as amended. Either Section 13 or Section 14 of the 1999 Constitution as amended, which state that the law, this constitution, is the power, that the people of Nigeria is the power under which the constitution was written. So from that section of the constitution, which I'm going to address this evening, the people of this region, these four region now that come together now to sue this presidency, have the right to make sure they organize their people, come out in public, and demand that they are no longer interested in Nigeria, that this constitution that they have given to the government, is this time they are withdrawing it. And withdrawing the constitution means that you are bringing down the constitution of the country, and the constitution is no more void, is no more valid. You see, once the people do that, the government, which is now going to be only two regions, the northeast and the northwest, they will have no other option other than to bring military and bring police and bring tanks to start shooting people. Now, how can these two regions now fight against the west, the southern part of Nigeria combined, and then the middle belt? It is impossible. You see, you have to check what other revolution, how the revolution took place in different country, in other country. It is because the people of those countries have the constitution. They are the constitution themselves. When revolution take place, it means that the people are revolting against the government. They are demanding to take back the constitution they gave to the government. That is what revolution is all about. And in Nigeria constitution, it is very clearly stated that the people of Nigeria is the constitution under which the constitution was written. So when Nigeria people come out, like this group now, just organize your different ethnic group, come out and demand that you are no longer interested in Nigeria, you are no longer interested in Nigeria, that because the Nigeria is not working anymore, for that reason, you are demanding the total disintegration of Nigeria so you can have your independent state to protect lives and property of your people. And the government, and you will now demand that because in the constitution of Nigeria, it is stated that the people of the Nigeria people are the constitution themselves. And this is what nobody is getting. That is the reason why you will see that people will rise up South America, and the government of a country in South America will fall down because the people are the constitution. That is why you will see in all over the world, in different countries where revolution took place, where people demand that the president must resign, the country must be restructured, and all this and that. It is because the people realize that the constitution of that country belongs to them, and the people are the constitution. Now, how can you come together, do great job, coming together as a group? You were able to bring in Pandef. You are able to bring in Ohanaeze Ndigbo. You are able to bring in Afenifere. You bring in another group from the Middle Belt. And all you people could do is to go to court, Ohanaeze Ndigbo, to demand 50 billion. That is a very big insult. And then Nyanwodo was telling us in a Zoom conference the other day that we should wait and hear. Very soon we are going to hear the breaking news about them dragging the president to court. And today, I wake up to hear this breaking news. I am disappointed. I am disappointed and very, very disappointed in what I am just reading now about this group from four different regions in Nigeria. Very, very disappointed. And this evening, I am going to make it rain on this different group, in case if they don't know their right. In case if they don't know their right, I am going to lecture them this evening on their right, so that they will use that right they have judiciously. What we are looking for Nigeria to be disintegrated is just a unity of purpose. The unity of purpose is this. Let me just read this so that people will understand what is going on. Let me read it so that people will understand what is going on. Now, the Fasoranti, Clark, Nwodo, and 13 others sue Buhari over lopsided appointment. Eminent socio-cultural leaders from Southern and the Middle Belt Nigeria have sued President Major General Muhammadu Buhari for $50 billion over marginalization of the people of the region in the appointment to security, quasi-security agencies and strategic agencies of the government. You see? And they are suing for $50 billion. This is not just the only welcome development. The only welcome development in this report is that they have come together. That is the only welcome development. That this is a joint suit, which means the group have come together. That is the only welcome development. Every other thing that followed this is greed and rubbish. And this is the reason why nobody will trust these people. This is the reason why they are receiving insult. How can you be suing the government or a terrorist-controlled government for $50 billion? Will $50 billion save the life that have been killed, that have been lost so far? Will $50 billion bring? Will $50 billion bring back life of people, women, children, those two-year-old kids that were killed and murdered in cold blood? Will this $50 billion bring back the security situation in Nigeria? The answer is no. The answer to all this and numerous one I did not mention, the answer is no. Now, why would you now go and start demanding for money? What are you going to use the money? Go to the villages, to the villagers, to the farmers, to the constituencies, to those who have lost their loved one to the Nigeria government sponsored herdsmen? The answer is no. So, what is the essence of the trust you? Now, people in the that has been marginalization. Now you went and go to court. Instead of you to demand for the freedom of your people, you are going to court to demand for 50 billion. Will 50 billion now give you a security chief from Igbo speaking part of Nigeria? Will 50 billion now bring back what they have done, all the meetings that I have done since 2015, all the security meetings that were no Igbo, no single Igbo speaking person, no single Igbo speaking person were involved in those security meetings? Who knows what they discuss, what they plan, and will the 50 billion now revive or make the mistake or return everything that have been stolen, whatever they have done from 2015 to 2020? 50 billion cannot do that. Now, let me read further. The 16th plaintiff filed the suit marked FCs, blah, 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 at the Federal High Court in Abuja on June 8, 2020. Among the plaintiffs are Ijaw leader, Chief A.K. Clark, the Afenifere leader, Chief Ruben Fasoranti, President General of Ohanaeze Ndi Igbo, Dr. John Nyanwodo, a leader of Middle Belt people, Dr. Pug Bitrus. They also include Dr. Bitrus, Chief Ayo Adebanjo, Alowi Bozimo, Mrs. Sarah Doketri, Chief Chukwuemeka Ezeife, Air Commodore Idongsit Nkanga, a former Deputy Governor of Lagos State, Bukno Akerele, Professor Julia Umukoro, Elder Stephen Banjoy. The rest are Alhaji Tijani Babatunde, Ms. Ron Obuaforibo, Mr. Adekola Ijogi, and Dr. Charles Nwakiako. The Federal Republic of Nigeria Buhari, the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice Abubakar Malami, the Clerk of the National Assembly Mohamed Sani Omolore, and the Federal Character Commission are the defendants sued in this suit. The suit was instituted on behalf of the defendant by 10 senior advocates of Nigeria, comprising Solomon Asemota, Tijani Ayalanja, Chuks Muama, Albert Akpomuje, Tayo Oyetibo, Pius Akubo, Miss Nella Ndam Rabana, Mike Ezokome, Akimpelu Onibande, and Ebun Olu Adeboruwa. You hired 10 senior advocate of Nigeria to fight for 50 billion. What a shame. What a shame. What kind of caricature have this organization, this group who claim to be representing their indigenous people, are bringing to the South and to the Middle Belt? This is a very big shame. A very big shame, and I just hope that after this evening, when I'm going to naked them and lecture them on what they should have done, believe me, it is not going to be easy, because this is an opportunity that we have waited for to crash Nigeria, and these people are using and misusing the opportunity in this very, very laughable manner. If you have agreed that this government has failed, not just the government has failed, if you have agreed that Nigeria cannot work again, because a lot of you are making mistake, believing that Buhari's tenure will come and go, believing that this present government will come and go. That is where you are making a very big mistake, because it can never come and go. You see this government? This government, if you do not do the right thing now, if you are waiting that 2023, somebody else will come, or another government will come, you are living in full paradise. You are living in mirage. It can never happen. This government have come to stay. The only thing that we remove this government is disintegration of Nigeria. They have found a way to keep the government of the day for 50 years if they want. That is the bitter truth I have to tell you today. You see this government you see today, they are not going anywhere. If you do not join us to disintegrate Nigeria, you are going to die and rot in hell at the end of the day, because they will make Nigeria hell on earth. You see, this government is not going anywhere. This government will not go anywhere. They have come to stay. If you do not join us to do justice, to put culpability where culpability is, solve this problem once and for all, this government you are waiting for, that in 2023 they are going to go away, you are going to live from 2023 in a very big full paradise. You are going to have your cushion. You are going to have your bed. You will be sleeping in full paradise. Remember, the full paradise is always a full paradise. It is not original paradise. So when you look at this, you will know that the people we are looking up to, especially the Igbos, they no longer trust Ohaneze Ndi Igbo. They no longer trust Ohaneze Ndi Igbo. And when we are looking at them, trying to see whether we will have a reason to trust these people, they every blessed day, they continue to give us reason never to trust them. Because I don't know the rationale behind filing a lawsuit for $50 billion instead of fighting for freedom of the people that they have divided. Nigeria has been divided. What it means is that the apartheid system in Nigeria has come to stay. And the only thing is division of Nigeria, disintegration of Nigeria. Join me this evening as I will make it rain on this five or four different group that have joined together to file a lawsuit for ordinary $50 billion. They should just tell us that what they are looking for. You see, the reason why most of these people don't want Nigeria to disintegrate, because they are looking for every opportunity to loot money. They are looking for every opportunity to demand for money from the government. Every opportunity that comes their way, they want to use it to make money. You see, this is the reason why we are not trusting them. This is the reason why we will never ever trust them. So join me this evening as I will make it rain on this group. And remember, the reason I'm going to make it rain on this group is not to insult them, is not to call them names, is not to invoke Amadoha, is not to invoke thunder. The reason I'm going to make it rain on them this evening is to lecture them, open their brain, and let them start to think that we can't just keep quiet and allow them to misuse the opportunity they should have to invoke the constitution of Nigeria that has been dormant. Invoking the constitution of Nigeria is by demanding, calling up the region where they come from. Afenifere should call Yoruba to come out. Ohaneze should call Biafrans to come out. David Clark should call the other part of Biafrans to come out. The Middle Belt should call their people to come out and demand the end to Nigeria. That is the only thing they should have done. And believe me, whether they have right to do that, yes, they have right to do that. They have every right to do that. And what we are looking at, and what we are looking for all this while, is a synergy like this one they have just done now. This is what this kind of unity and unity of purpose and cooperation is what has delayed disintegration of Nigeria. And instead of them to think towards the direction of getting freedom, they want to get money first. Now, before I go, let them come publicly to tell us that they are demanding their part, the part of 13 billion that was allocated to the 12 northern states to fight locust, grasshopper, and ants. That because of that 13 billion that was allocated to them, they are now demanding their own share of that money. Because if you divide 50 billion into four, you know how much. It is not up to that. It is not even up to 13 billion, like the 12 northern states. So let them come clearly to say that they are not representing the people. Rather, they are just hungry elders, hungry politicians, looking for every opportunity that they should have used to demand the freedom of their people and demand for money. So what this means is that they are now having what we call trade by barter, selling the freedom and the right of the people for mere 50 billion, thinking that Buhari will come and go. They don't know that Buhari will never come and go. Buhari have come to stay. You see that name Buhari in Aso Rock? He is going to stay there even if he want the next 50 years. This Buhari you are seeing now, that man that they call Buhari, that man is a young man, is going to contest election again. And believe me, he is going to declare himself a winner and you cannot do anything. That is what these people don't know. Even if this man don't come back in 2023, that is if Nigeria continues to be a country. Let me just make it very clear. If Nigeria continues to be a country in 2023, anybody that comes to contest under this man that is in Aso Rock now is your president. There is nothing you can do about it. It is only talk. The Fulani voodoo is dealing with you people. Fulani voodoo have finished you all. You are all living a fake life. The Fulani voodoo is working on you every day, every night, every morning, every afternoon. You see, in case you have forgotten, let me give you an instance that just happened. The instances is that this man you see in Aso Rock, he did not present a certificate. He was he became a president. They say he need a NEPA bill to present a NEPA bill as a certificate. He went to the one that died. He went to London to get a fake certificate from the WAEC office from Cambridge. He came back from London, and you did not ask yourself, how can an educational institution, release a certificate to somebody, a different person, who did not sit for the exam? But Abba Kyere went to Cambridge and collected a certificate and came back to Nigeria, presented the certificate. Nobody did nothing and nobody would do anything. And that issue died natural death. Now, this same man, these same people, they removed the CGN Onegan. And all the senior advocate of Nigeria, they shout heaven and earth, they are going to do this, they are going to do that. That case died what? Natural death in Nigeria. Nobody did anything, nobody will do anything, and that is the end of Onegan. As if that is not enough, they charge him for another offense. That case died natural death. As if that enough, they begin to manufacture a lot of evidences. In fact, Onegan was sacked. They started looking for evidence. And that was against the Constitution of Nigeria. That is not enough. Nobody talked anything. Nobody said anything. That issue died and died natural death. Now, they bring Tanko Muhammad. Tanko Muhammad was not called to bar, the Nigeria Bar Association. His name is not there. In the bar record, in Nigeria Bar Association record, his name is...